Hey guys, it's JD from Eastwood, and in this video, we're gonna be taking a closer look at how to deal with rust. In a couple of minutes, we're gonna look at how you can remove rust on small parts, clean and protect frames, and how to patch bodywork. There's really three ways I figure to handle rust, and that is one, with chemicals, two, with paints like rust encapsulators, and three, what we're gonna start with today, and the most simple method, and that is mechanically. First off, let's address something that most of you Project Car guys aren't gonna wanna hear. If you have a spot that's just too far gone, you have that really big flaky rust that you could just push right through with your fingers, you're definitely not gonna fix that. The only solution is to cut it out, clean the surrounding area, and weld in a patch panel. Check out this Cushman scooter, for example. This came from the 1940s, and the rust on this thing was just too much. You could see the holes all over this thing, super bad. Those had to be removed. After Matt cut those out, he made a template to perfectly match his curved over shape, and then he went to town trying to copy it in his pipe anvils. He then gave the surrounding edges a good cleanup with the grinder and die grinder to get nice clean welds. He then tacked his new panel into place, gave the panel the rest of the shape that it needed, and finished welded to send it home. Also, check out Mark's repair for this hole in a door that he fixed recently. This isn't a hole from rust per se, but it's a hole nonetheless, and the repair is gonna be the exact same. He masked the area he wanted to replace, and then he actually used the panel saw to get those perfectly straight cuts when he cut out the damaged panel and when he cut out the new panel as well. The panel saw is also great for doing plunge cuts, which you're gonna need if you plan on working in the center of a panel. He then used the 8-inch bead roller to match the style line on the door, and he got his gentle contour in his panel with a mini English wheel. And after that, he prepped the area with the deburring tool. That's really nice because you could deburr from the top of the edge and from the bottom of the edge as well. He then stitch welded his patch panel into place to keep it from heating up too much and warping. He did some finish work to roll the edges over the bottom, and after a quick coat of roll-on primer, the door was looking as good as new. All right, so there are, of course, ways of working on rust without completely replacing pieces entirely, which, if you're working with the frame, for instance, I'd strongly advise against cutting and welding unless you really know what you're doing. Check out this frame that Matt prepared. He started with a wire wheel on a Contour SCT, and that really knocked off almost all the rust from this frame with ease. It took him a little elbow grease, but this frame was pretty much ready for a coat of rust encapsulator in no time at all. After all, SCT stands for Surface Conditioning Tool, and it's really purpose-built for this application. It has a powerful 9-amp double-insulated motor with a fully adjustable RPM anywhere from 1,000 to 3,700. Matt was using the wire scaling drum for most of this, but there's plenty of different wheels available, like different grit stripping drums, finishing drums, buffing and spiral sewn drums, scaling drums, flap sanding drums, and more. Here's a video of it absolutely ripping through the paint on this Porsche with the 40 grit abrasive wheel. In my opinion, that shows the Contour SCT is a great tool for preparing metal for really any purpose. To go back to the frame for a second, Matt also followed up with the needle scaler, which is also amazing for removing those huge, scaly flakes of rust, or to just get in all those tight nooks and crannies, which is exactly what he used it for. Last but certainly not least, as far as mechanical methods go, and probably the method that'll give you the best finish, is to use something from our full line of blasters. Blasting is a process of using compressed air to blow abrasive media across a piece to remove rust. That media can be glass, silicone carbide, aluminum oxide, walnuts, what have you. It'll depend on what your project is. Here's Kevin working on his Camaro project. This is gonna be the best way to remove rust from deep pits, hard to reach areas. You can see the paint and rust just fly right off when you're using one of these things. Also, here's Cody working on his Camaro, same thing. Paint, rust, hard to reach areas. You can see all of that debris flying right off to reveal clean, bare metal underneath. We have a full line of outdoor blasters, great for the larger project like those two Camaros we just looked at, but also we have a bunch of different sized blast cabinets for smaller stuff as well, like wheels, valve covers, brackets, the works. So moving right along, let's talk about the chemical methods of rust removal. These are really great if you don't feel like putting in all of that elbow grease. These are your rust dissolvers, your converters, and your fast etch. Starting off with Rust Dissolver, this is a non-acid based product that's designed for more of the soaking of small parts for an extended period of time, usually overnight in most cases. This comes in a quart or gallon sizes, and you can get it as either a gel or a liquid. Liquid is gonna be great to submerge your entire part in. As a demonstration, we submerged this absolutely huge 33 Chrysler dash, and after a good overnight soak, you can see the rust just falls right off of this thing, and honestly, it did a great job. This metal is coming up on 90 years old, and it looks fantastic after a great bath in this stuff. If you can't submerge your entire part, you can go with the gel. You can brush it on, wrap it in saran wrap, leave it overnight, like Joe did with this rusted portion of our go-kart frame. The next day, he gave it a quick brush down, rust came right off, good as new. Now, Fast Etch is gonna be the next product that we touch on. This works in a similar way, however, this is acid-based, and it's designed for application onto a surface via a spray bottle, or you can drop your part into a bath of this stuff as well. This is done for a short period of time, typically 20, 30 minutes, we'll have your rust taken care of. This comes in a 16 ounce, a 32 ounce, and gallon sizes. Check out how simple the process was when we used Fast Etch for our Corvair Project quarter panel. So you can see the streaky rust on there that we were working with. All we did was spray it on, then we gave the area a good scrub with a non-woven scuff pad to really work the Fast Etch in. We let that sit for a little bit, we came back, wiped off the excess with a clean rag, and look how much of an improvement we got for almost no work whatsoever. Now, the really nice thing about Fast Etch is that it seals your metal in from any flash rust, because when you let it dry into your metal, it leaves a zinc phosphate coating that's gonna prevent your metal from oxidizing. Great if you're the weekend warrior type. You can leave your project sit for all week if you have to, and then come back to it whenever you have time. Next up, let's talk about Rust Converter. Converter reacts chemically with rust that's already on there, so you need a decent amount of rust in order for this to work. It turns it into a hard, polymeric, paintable material, perfect for stubborn, heavy rust. It comes in a spray aerosol, a quart, or a gallon. Now, one caveat to Converter is that it's not UV stable. It won't oxidize like bare metal, but it will require a coat of paint just the same. For that, you'd want a rust encapsulator, a chassis black, or sometimes even both. Now, speaking about rust encapsulator, that brings us to the final section of our video, painted rust solutions. This is rust encapsulator and internal frame coating. Rust encapsulator can be applied right over rusted metal, rust converter, or even clean bare metal, and it seals it from moisture, corrosion, and UV damage. Plus, any rust that you might have missed is encapsulated, and that chemically prevents it from spreading underneath. Let's go back to that frame from a little earlier on in the video. Once the rust has been removed mechanically as best as possible, Matt followed up with Rust Encapsulator Plus. He loaded this in the spray gun, 1.3 to 1.4 tip, and went to town. The first coat dried in about 20 minutes. He threw down a second coat after about an hour. And after that, he allowed 8 hours to pass before finishing up with a top coat of chassis black. This stuff also holds up extremely well to heat, as it can withstand up to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. It's also great for its ease of use. You can apply it with the aerosol, you can brush it on, or you can spray it out of a spray gun. You might be familiar with Rust Encapsulator, but you might not be familiar with just some of the crazy options we have for this stuff. You can get it in the original textured, you can get it in the original rubberized. There's also a few different colors to pick from, so you can easily match whatever color it is that you're working with. Now, this comes in three formulas. There's the original, there's the plus, and there's the platinum. Original is gonna be the tried and true OG. Plus is gonna give you twice the corrosion resistance, and platinum is gonna give you three times the corrosion resistance. All three formulas are tested in an independent lab to ensure that you can be confident when you apply Rust Encapsulator to your beloved project car. However, this stuff isn't just for project cars. It can also be used on a variety of stuff. Marine, snow plows, motorcycles, farm equipment. It's even been used in bridges. It's used in the oil and refinery pipeline industry. It's used for military vehicle protection, and even more impressive, it's even been used on salt sprayers. The original Eastwood guy, Randy, he even put platinum to the test on his dad's salt sprayer, and it is still going strong to this day. Now, similarly to rust encapsulator, we also have our internal frame coating. Now, this is gonna work similarly in the fact that it's designed to chemically encapsulate and stop rust in its tracks, but the formula is a little bit different as it's designed to work in those hard to reach places that water just loves to get into and sit and cause a bunch of corrosion. Check out how this was applied to this mid-2000s Tacoma frame. First, he masked off any holes in the frame that he didn't want this to leak out of. This is designed to spray deep into those hard to reach channels, and because of that, it does get everywhere in the frame, but it also does sometimes get a little bit messy, so keep that in mind with the prep work. The aerosol can that this sprays out of includes a brass 360 degree conical nozzle on a flexible 24 inch long tube. That reaches in your frame to spray internal frame coating in a perfect radial pattern for complete coverage. You want to make sure that you totally cover the inside of your frame and it'll fully cure in about 24 hours. Quick tip here, if you do have a corner to go around, you could tape that tube to a straightened coat hanger or a piece of TIG filler wire, and that way you could bend it to the perfect shape you need to go around whatever corner you need. Internal frame coating comes in either black or green, and it's perfect for adding corrosion resistance to the inside of any frame, but it also works on any of the internal areas of a vehicle that are common for rust. A-pillars, hoods, rocker panels, and more. Press the button to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We're giving away a MIG 180 welder at 500,000 subscribers. Also, make sure you head over to our channel and check it out. We post tons of great how-to content like you saw right here. You're definitely gonna like it. Thanks for watching. I'm JD. Keep it right here at Eastwood to do the job right.